Welcome to prefabricated structure module 2, which is prefabricated components. Under this video, construction of roof and floor slabs. Roofing members can be divided into two groups, short span and long span roofing members. We know that one-way slab and two-way slab, there are two types of slabs which we usually consider for our RCC constructions. The similar way, there are one is short span and long span roofing members under prefabricated structures. The short span member rests on purlins, while long span directly supported by the main girders. Now we can say the slabs are supported by the beams, whereas here the short span is supported by the purlins and the long span will be supported by the main girders. Short span roofing members, the reinforced plan mode of porous hollow tiles, they are of in the types of porous hollow tiles, lightweight concrete, roofing material, small reinforcement, concreting or roofing materials. Among the long span roof members, the reinforced concrete members are more efficiently working in this part. So roofing is similar to the RCC slabs itself only, but the things some are different, such as we are supporting the slabs with openings in between, but whereas the roofing members will be supported by the purlins and girders. Now, how these purlins and girders are being there? Either they may be a steel joist or they may be a prefabricated RCC joist or concrete joist itself only, which can be used as a supporting members for the roofing members. So the roofing members are again in the different types. So the first type of the roofing member is reinforced planks made of porous hollow tiles. So these are of a porous hollow tiles where it will be having a longitudinal circular hole. Means the lengthwise there are holes, as we have seen in previous videos. There were some as known as roofing members, known as column members, known as wall members. So the roofing members consist of a porous tiles. Porous tiles means we can say that a hollow member holes are provided in the lengthwise direction of the particular planks of reinforced roofing members. The thickness of the tiles and the upper side of the are provided with longitudinal groove. So we can see that the thickness is provided such that they can consider the particular hollow section, means the whole section, and the sides are provided with the grooves, such as we have seen the grooves in the clay tiles. Clay tiles, we have usually seen the grooves wherein one interlocks with the other tile, by which they cannot be allowing the water to enter inside the house. Similarly, there are grooves which will provide the interlocking between the roofing planks, and they are not going to allow any type of water inside this particular joints. So for that reason, the upper side grooves are provided. Reinforcement is placed into these grooves, which are subsequently filled with a cement mortar to make them homogeneous, to make them one particular body. The reinforcements are also allowed into the particular grooves. These grooves will make such as the things will be easy to get molded, means they will be directly getting monolithic with the beam connections or with the slab connection or with the wall connections, which will be later filled with the cement mortar, which gets set and becomes as the one monolithic whole section. The reinforcement porous tiles planks having a length of 2.3 meter and a thickness of 6 to 10 centimeter and a width of 20 centimeter can be produced of these tiles. There are two kinds which are exist. So the first kind is the heat insulating and has a unit weight of 750 kg per meter cube, and the second kind is of a load bearing its unit weight varies in the 1100 kg per meter cube range. So this is used for production of reinforced planks. So still the reinforced planks, which are made up of porous hollow tiles, are having a disadvantage of using the porous tiles in the question of roofing covers, is the material of latter is highly moisture absorbing and therefore non-frost resistance. So when we see that the hollow sections are provided, these hollow sections will allow the water to get stored into this particular hollows tiles, and which will be allowing for having a moisture absorbing, means the thickness between the hollow section and the soft normal section will be very less, whereas compared to the hole thickness, and therefore the non-frost resistance will be there. So we can say that the slab will not be allowing water from one side to another side also, because water is collected in this hollow part and it will be drained out easily, and it may not be coming from the other side. The roof should be protected from moisture, and hence it should be rough rendered with a lime mortar. So to allow the not to allow the particular moisture content to get into these particular slabs or particular roofing members, when we consider, so dampness will be occurring. The dampness should not occur if the moisture is present. In this account, we can allow the cement mortar with a lime mixture. So lime mixture, what it will be doing, the lime, it will be not allowing the water to restrain at the particular place. It will be allowing just to flow it off from the roofing members. So some limiting moment is there for the particular sections when we provide with a required width or required length. That time it is MI is equals to 0.9 into bracket MACO minus 3N divided by N minus S. So now here S is having one more formula, such as square root of summation MCAO minus MI square divided by N minus 1. So now one is MI, another one is MI, wherein this particular MI, for the first formula, MI is known as limiting moment, and MACO is known as arithmetic mean of ultimate moment. Arithmetic mean of ultimate moment means we are going to consider the summations of all the moments which are going to occur, or at the edges, or at the mid-span, or it is a simply supported, or it is a fixed conditions. Based upon the conditions we are able to have the arithmetic mean of the ultimate moment. MI, this MI is for used in this S equation. Value of the ultimate moment belonging to the individual planks, where I is equals to 1 to n number. So it is depending upon how many number of planks are available. N, number of load testings, how many number of load tests are we have conducted in that manner. S is scattered of moments, how many types of scattering of moments are going to occur. In this way, we are going to have some limiting moment for the reinforced planks made of porous hollow tiles. The second part is lightweight concrete roofing members. So which is another lightweight concrete we are going to use. So lightweight concrete roofing members, which give a role in addition to space bordering and load bearing things. So because of load bearing of the walls, the lightweight concretes are more utilized in prefabricated structures. Or we can say, as wall loads will be carrying much less amount of load, the roof slabs should be having a lightweight, then it will be more matter. So for that reason, we can say lightweight concrete is one of the material which has used as the member of roofing members. In heat insulating, and so that application of the separate heat insulating layer is not necessary. As the material is lightweight in concrete, heat insulation is not required, because lightweight material is having to absorb the thing but not allow the thing outside its particular body. So this material can be used as the roofing members. Lightweight concrete roofing members can only be applied if there is a possibility of their reinforcement. So we can see the slab or the roofing member is having to go with a load coming on it. Some dead load will be there, or superimposed dead load will be there, live load will be there acting on the particular members. At this time we require some reinforcements. As usual, we provide for a design of slab, the same amount of reinforcement can be provided, but this reinforcement will be somewhat different because it is already a precast. So we are not going beyond the slab dimensions. So in this dimensions, the extra cover dimensions will be more for the roofing members in this type of construction. It requires a bond between the steel and the lightweight concrete for ensuring the transmission of tensile force acting in the steel bars to the concrete with the steel bars sliding. Hence, it is necessary to protect the reinforcement against the corrosion. So why the corrosion is most important thing in this prefabricated? We sometimes allow the bars to get embedded into the supports. That time when the reinforcements are open to the atmosphere, it comes into contact with a chemical action and a water. That time it happens, the corrosion is going to act. In this part of view, we have to see that the ensuring that the concrete is totally covering the reinforcement and it is able to transfer the forces which are acting in the steel to the concrete. And the forces which are acting in the concrete, they can be transferred to the steel. So which can be also going to bear a load which is acting on them, such as dead load, live load, or any other superimposed dead load or superimposed live load. Lightweight, again, though from the point of view of strength, lightweight concrete on the quality LC. So this is the one of the point of quality numbering they are using in the prefabricated manufacturing. LC70 or LC100 are quite suitable on the production of roofing members with rectangular cross section and thickness of about 7.5 to 2.5 centimeters. So we can see some centimeters of thickness can be provided, 7.5 centimeter to 2.5 centimeters. Usually will be very thin sections will be allowed. So these sections may be using, may not be using. For this reason, the with the less thickness, the steel reinforcement also get corroded. The weight of the cement roofing member is about 750 kg per meter cube. They have a width of 50 centimeter, a thickness of 7.5 to 25 centimeter. So this is 25 centimeter. This part of you just eliminate the 2.5, it is totally 25 centimeter. So they have a width of 50 centimeter to thickness of 7.5 to 25 centimeter and a length of 1.75 meter to 6 meters. Prefab roofing members can be produced on of concrete mode in the usual way. So in the usual way, we can also provide them using lightweight materials on a gravel and a sand for aggregates. In the case of prefabricated structures, the steel wires must be embedded. So here reinforcement is in type of steel wires. Steel wires we are using as a reinforcement embedded to the concrete to have the availability of which is at least C300. So this is a strength membering for numbering for the steel wires which we are going to use. Small reinforced concrete roof members. This is another type wherein the small reinforced 3 meter and 1 meter approximately and a thickness of 4 centimeter and a 35 centimeter. This is of something called as the opposite directions. It is grooved one, or we can say a small amount of roofing members. This members is acting as a girders wherein the support taking and load transferring. Small reinforced members, concrete roofing members, is essentially a precast simply supported ribbed reinforced concrete slab. A width of the member is around about 50 to 120 centimeter. So it can also go up to 3 meter, not maximum than 3 meter, sometimes if the thickness is more increasing, which is of about 35 centimeters, and for 1 meter, 4 centimeter is more than enough. Large reinforced concrete roofing members. The large reinforced concrete roofing members resting directly on the main girders of a structure represents a more advanced kind of precast roofing members. So these are directly supporting. So these members are manufactured in the length corresponding to the spacing of frames, 6 to 10 meters. Their width is about 1.3 to 1.8 meter. They are directly supported by the main girders so that the purlins are not required, as some purlins are there used. If we provide a large panels wherein the span is changing, this type when we consider, so the purlins are not required, they can directly support on the main girders. The large roofing member consists of 2 longitudinal edge ribs and cross ribs, and a slab having of a thickness of 2.5 to 3 meter, and the two-way reinforcement is provided. So here again comes with a one-way slab and two-way slab, the two-way reinforcement is provided for this type of roofing member. The member connected to each other and to the frame girders from the unified continuous roofing structure. Member is connected by the frame girders from unified connecting continuing roofing structures. Flooring members. In industrial buildings, the use of prefab members for floors consists of precast joints and flooring members. So we have seen the flooring members or the roofing members. A flooring members is designed for a span of 9 meter and for the bearing of a live load of 1000 kg per meter square. After the members are placed in final positions, a longitudinal load bearing reinforcement and stirrups are placed in the trough from between the longitudinal ribs and additional members. A continuous reinforcement is placed on the top of these members. Thereafter, a 5 cm incised concrete layer is cast on the top of the members, and trough between the longitudinal ribs are also filled up with concrete. In this way, the slab is transformed into a span of 6 meter and live load of 500 kg per meter square, and a weight of about 1450 kg are widely used. Flooring members are used for a small load. Similarly to roofing members, can also be made of a lightweight concrete. These members are used chiefly in houses and public buildings. The flooring members rest in general joist that they are cantilever like part. The weight of a flooring member should not exceed 5 tons. Otherwise, the storage and transportation as well as the placing of the members using the present available equipment would be difficult. Flooring membering spans from 6 meter and load taking, which is there 80 to 500 kg per meter square. G, that is the weight, we can say 1450 kg, and they can be transverse rib at a spacing of about 1.5 meter square. Same as pre-stressed reinforcement, which is used of about 12 to 20 mm diameter. So pre-stressed reinforcement is how it is a tendons. So small wires are bounded into the part, and then we are considering, and this type of things we are going to put into the flooring members. So this video was related to the construction of floor members and roof members. Some part of roof members will be again continued. Thank you. See you in the next video.